Okay, today I want to talk to you about what type of gear you need to start off riding. Or just in general, what gear you should normally be using while riding. And obviously I'm going to give my preference on what exactly that should be. So guys, the first item you should have while riding is going to be your gloves. These are gloves. If you happen to be unfortunate in class for whatever reason, unless you really get thrown around, your first instinct is going to be to put your hands down to protect yourself. If you like your skin, get gloves, because your skin's not going to hold up. You're going to lose all your skin in your hands. It's not going to be pretty. I post a picture of what that would look like, but it's just fucking disgusting. So, the first thing you guys need are gloves. Now, like I said, this is all my opinions on everything. When I look for gloves, I look for leather. Leather is very strong. Leather will hold up to a crash. The gloves that I have are the Alpinestar FT8 non-tensive. These gloves are very good when it's 40 degrees out. Not that I ride in that because it's fucking cold. But I could go small distances in that. These gloves are kind of excessive for what I do. They're very warm, and that's why I bought them. And there's a hole in them, I can feel it. It's got a pinky support, so if I crash, my pinky can't slide. It's got carbon knuckles or something weird like that. It's got plastic supports on the knuckles. It's got a heavy-duty Gopro snap, which is getting a little fit for that part. There it is. So, it gives me that extra support. It's not the cuff or the wrist length, it's a little further. When it is pulled out, it does help keep you warm, because you don't have that separation between your gloves and your jacket. Once again, this is all my personal perspective. Don't get the $20 mechanics gloves. I see a lot of people riding those. If you crash bad, they're going to get worn out, and you're going to get your hands all messed up. Honestly, they're better than no gloves, so I guess my argument is pick or choose. But mechanics gloves are better than nothing. Leather gloves are better than mechanics gloves. These gloves I'm wearing right now, I'm going to take a guess at $130. I do know two people that have the same pair, similar pair. One has the newer model, one has the vintage. So that's my perspective on that. Number two, you need a jacket. I mean, you can't really prevent how you fall, at least. I mean, 90% of the time you can. So you need a jacket. A lot of these companies that are coming out with Kevlar hoodies. And there's another one too, and I forget what it is. I guess that would be a good one. But once again, this is my opinion only, and I'm gonna take it a lot. The only way to do it right is a leather jacket. Depending on where you live, leather may not be an option. It may just depend if it's too hot. And that's fine, I clearly understand it, because I live in Buffalo, where it's not that warm, and it's still 90 degrees plus, and I can't wear a leather jacket. It's too damn hot. You stop at one red light, and you're sweating bullets, and you don't feel good. It's too warm. borrowed from a friend, it was used. There's nothing wrong with getting a used jacket other than it was a little dirty. But I got a great deal on it, and like I said, it was a fun 500k. So this jacket here, it's very heavy, very bulky, very thick. It's got upper arm support, it's got elbow, it's got shoulder, it's got back support, and the inner support in the jacket. The other thing it doesn't have is chest. But not that many jackets have chest supports that I know of. Maybe girl jackets, but. There's enough padding and the leather wasn't too much thick enough where I should be safe. Maybe a broken bone here and there, but I'll be safe. Same thing with your gloves. If you go down at speed with a mesh jacket, your mesh jacket's just gonna get ripped all the fuck up. You know, like I said, it's better than no jacket, and that's fine, but for the price of some of these jackets, I just feel, in my opinion only again, that you might as well spend a tiny bit more, an extra $50, and get yourself a leather jacket. That goes for mesh jackets. Definitely not leave. Footwear. fine for acceptable footwear on a motorcycle. Next up to that would be boots. The boots are a lot, usually, the boots are a lot thicker, a lot more supportive. I am currently running with heel toe. Once again, I know a lot of people that wear motorcycle boots. I personally have them. I love them. I used to work 2 miles away from my house. So that's when I bought this jacket, that's when I bought these gloves. I can ride in 33, so I'm going to snow now. These are the first boots I'm riding in. Steel toe boots. I wear steel toe boots because I wear steel toe boots. Yeah, guys, if you crash your boots and sneakers, your poison, I'm going to wear my helmet. Now in the line of that, the helmet's got to be COG if you do wear one. If you don't need a helmet, I don't know the laws, but I'm assuming there's something wanting in a DOD helmet. You have the option of this as well, and other supporting protection agencies. My first helmet, I don't even know what it was yellow, that's my bike. I got it with my heavy-duty gloves and leather jacket. Since then, I upgraded to Icon Armada. And I love that helmet. I had the Elemental.
So after I got that helmet, I had that helmet for 2 years. I got rid of that helmet this year, actually. I went to go upgrade.
Dave out.